Well, friends, now let us study another form of dielectric heating, which is radio frequency heating. In fact, it is known as high frequency dielectric heating. It refers to the heating of dielectric materials with electromagnetic energy at frequencies between 1 and 300 megahertz. Here in this case, food is placed between electrodes and a radio frequency voltage is applied across the electrode. It involves the transfer of electromagnetic energy directly into the product, and thereby it induces this electromagnetic energy which is directly put into the product, it induces bolumetric heating, and which is mainly because of the frictional interaction between the molecule. So, as far as the heating process mechanism is concerned, it is almost similar to that in the microwave, but the generation and operation or type of the system, there are certain differences. It has higher penetration power than microwaves. Radio frequency heating allows greater concentration of heat energy selectively in the location of heating and accuracy in control of heating duration is also better here in this case than that of the microwave. Thickness of the food, however, is restricted by the distance between the capacitor plates. Let us see the principle of radio frequency heating. It is also almost in the similar fashion like that in the microwave heating. Here, space charge polarization or orientation polarization are the phenomena. There is the molecular reorientation and friction due to continuous realignment of the molecules, or ionic movement towards the oppositely charged electrodes, and the rapid change in polarity causes the resistive heating equivalent of the ionic conduction of the electricity. So, this is the principle of the radio frequency heating. Regarding the mechanism, of course, here in this case, the electromagnetic energy transfers directly into the product. Therefore, it induces bolumetric heating due to the frictional interaction between the molecules. The food is placed between two capacitor plates, and it plays the role of the dielectric, where high frequency alternating electric field is applied. In fact, the capacitor plates, they are the one where the dielectric is applied and where frequency they just pass the energy to the food. Such field will force polar molecule, that is water, to constantly realign themselves with the electric field, and this molecular movement is very fast due to high frequency of the field, and it will cause the generation of heat within the food by energy dissipation caused by the molecular friction. So, this is how the heat is generated inside. Regarding the equipment, radio frequency heating equipment, the fundamental components include a generator and an applicator. The generator is only for the generation of the radio frequency waves, whereas the applicator is for the application of the RF power to the food, and its main part is the electrode. You can see here in this figure, there is electrodes here, there is the insulating tube here, the food material is kept here, these are the flanges to hold the electrode, and of course, the radio frequency generator is here. So, the radio frequency that is the which is generated here, it is passed through this electrode, and through this electrode then it is sent to the product, right. So, the shape of the electrode determines the shape of the generated field. Rod electrodes and plate electrodes are the common types of electrode which are used in this radio frequency heating. The electric field strength is determined by the frequency, applied voltage and distance of the electrode. The distance of the electrode of course, is limited by the applied voltage. You cannot keep it at a very large distance, that is what are the voltage applied within that region there, so that it can pass or transmit the energy. The maximum electrode distance, thus the maximum product thickness is determined by the necessity to avoid arcing between the two electrodes. So, these are the considerations for deciding the electrode, for taking the heating potential etcetera of the process. RF heating like microwave heating has several advantages. It results in rapid and uniform heating process. It has a higher penetration depth, high efficiency, it results in short resistance times and no heat transfer surfaces, involvement of no heat transfer surfaces. So, it generally results into better quality products and more efficient processes. It can be applied extensively in various food process operations for both for the preservation purposes, for improvement in the quality, for improvement in the process efficiency. It has common application like in any other heat process. It can also be used for drying purposes, for pasteurization, for blanching, thawing, for meat processing, sterilization, for even baking or even toasting or after baking that heating of the bread etcetera. So, it has a wide ranging application in food processing for preparation of the products or for improvement in the quality of the product. Some report in the literature, there is reference you can see here, that is for what are the successful applications of radio frequency heating in food processing, like for the thawing of the frozen foods, the frequency is ranging between 14 to 40 megahertz have been applied by various researchers in various products like in egg, fruit, vegetable, fish, meat etcetera. For tempering of the meat, radio frequency in the range of 10 to 300 megahertz has been applied. For post baking drying of the bakery products, about 25-27 megahertz has been applied successfully in cookies, crackers, snack foods etcetera. For pasteurization of meat, cured ham, sausages, emulsion etcetera, the radio frequency of the ranging from 9 to 60 megahertz has been used. For cooking purposes, in the case of ham, about 14 megahertz RF frequency is used. For roasting, there is a cocoa bean, even it successful has been applied by some researchers, all right, and using as a electro technology application center, and the radio frequency they have reported is to the range of 60 megahertz. So, this data or this shows that the RF heating can be successfully applied for different food processing operations. So now we will take a few cases and we will see that what is, how effective it is and some advantages of it. For example, in the radio frequency drying, you can see in this picture, this is the typical decrease in drying time. You can see here in this figure that the same level of moisture content, the time required in radio frequency heating is reduced to more than 2 and 3 times, that is very less. So, it can be the desired operation, that is it becomes very, very advantageous process for drying. Okay. The process efficiency can be removed, right? Even drying rate is increased significantly in comparison with the conventional drying processes, and of course, the drying rate is increased, drying time is reduced. So, the process results into the energy saving. Moreover, in some applications, it improves the product quality, and the improvement in the product quality, that is the degree of improvement we get in the product quality, it justifies actually the even little more cost involvement of the cost, it is higher cost, capital investment, etcetera, or energy generation cost, etcetera, that can be overcome by having greater or bigger product advantages. Another interesting application of radio frequency is the radio frequency assisted fluidized bed drying. Fluidization would result in more uniform exposure of particulates to electromagnetic energy. These are the in the figure some fluidized based RF drying systems are shown. The radio frequency dryer has proven to be effective when it is fitted after the conventional baking ovens. And this results actually in the better quality products if it is fitted, that is a small unit of the radio frequency, if it is fitted in the baking line after the baking oven, right, it controls the moisture of the product more accurately and more uniformly, and which gives the added benefits to the product quality. Fresh pasta is pre-dried in hot air to 18% moisture content, and then it can be given to the combined system, that is where this both hot air as well as RF are available for drying. So, from then in the secondary stage in the combined system, that is to it is to RF drying, this moisture content is brought down to 13%. So, if these are the suggested, if this two stage drying, that is conventional hot air drying followed by radio frequency drying, if it is used, quality of the pasta is improved, its characteristics of the pasta is improved significantly. And again, few researchers, they have worked and they have come up with the data results. They have suggested that drying times are reduced from 8 hours to 90 minutes, right, bacterial counts it reduces by 15 times, there is reduction in energy consumption to the tune of 20 to 25%, drying tunnel in various systems may be 36 to 48 meters into 8 meters, clean up time is reduced to 24 to 6 person hours, no case hardening in the product. So, in the different applications for different purposes, that is people have suggested that this becomes a better and efficient process. Radio frequency assisted thawing, it becomes a rapid means of thawing of the meat and seafoods. It enhances the product freshness quality, it is more suitable for industrial heating of meats. radio frequency has greater penetration depth than the microwave, you've seen. So, it has a better possibility of applying the industrial heating of the muscles, etcetera. By suitable radio frequency treatment, thawing of meat block to within a target temperature range of -1 to +5 degrees Celsius is feasible. That is without much increase in the temperature of the muscle, thawing is possible. In some experiments, when this frozen white fish was thawed in a 6 kilowatt commercial scale RF unit operated at frequencies ranging from 36 to 40 megahertz, the duration of RF heating was reduced to few minutes compared to 16 hours in air based thawing system or 3 hours in water based thawing system. And this radio frequency thawing resulted in less drip loss and better odor and flavor. Radio frequency energy can be used for baking purposes. RF heating has a good application in baking industry. The addition of a relatively small, as I told you earlier, small RF unit to the end of the conventional baking line results in substantial increase in the product yield and improve the product quality. The post baking of biscuits like cookies, etcetera, result in the completely uniform moisture profile in the product. And this capability enables the baker to increase the oven line speed and develop the desired crumb structure and even desired color, texture in the products, and so on. It has good application in meat processing. I explained earlier, it reduces cooking times up to 1/25 of the conventional cooking times in water bath. RF heating results in the the results of the RF heating indicated that the surface of the radio frequency cooked products are heated at a faster rate than the center. The radio frequency cooked samples had lower juice losses and they have also acceptable color, they have acceptable water holding capacity. That is, the product cooked or heated by radio frequency heating, they have better acceptability in the terms of their color, water holding capacity, etcetera. The textural attributes of the RF cooked whole muscle meat are significantly better than that of the water bath cooked samples. The RF cooked ground beef had higher springiness, chewiness, lower hardness than that in the water bath cooked sample. So, all these results indicate that yes, it has a good potential, it can be applied for meat cooking. Similarly, it can be used for the post harvest treatment and disinfestation of the fruits. Several results indicate that the insects can be easily killed by this RF heating, right, and therefore, they can be used for increasing the shelf life of the grains, all right. They can be used for fumigation of the grains, for all those commodities which are likely to be spoiled by disinfestation, and the better application will be for the dried fruits, etcetera. The dried fruits, etcetera, sometimes support the growth of insects, etcetera, in it. So, they can be, ok. So, the processors, in fact, are seeking alternative to some more traditional fumigation agents. So, here this RF heating provides an alternative source. The last factors of the radio frequency are common pests, insects are larger than that of the fruit nut. So, it shows that the fruit nut without causing the heating of the fruit nut, one can kill the insect and then it becomes a good application without destroying the or without raising the temperature of the heat net, etcetera. Its a bioactive structure can be retained in this. So, another that is, you all know that is RFID tags. They have wide ranging application, not only in food processing industry, but in that industry, but in the food processing also, they have a good application. Radio frequency identification tags, they work much like a barcode or uniquely identify a large number of products. Okay. The RFID component of the tag have two parts. That is one, a microchip that stores the process information, and then an antenna which receives and transmits the signal. They can incorporate additional information like details of the product and manufacturer. They can transmit the measured environmental factors such as temperature, etcetera, temperature, relativity, etcetera, during, or they can be used to for the tracing the products, for recording the information. So, for various useful operations, etcetera. So, this can be used for different food processing industries. This RFID tag has the potential to increase efficiency of operations, improved asset visibility, traceability, decrease reliance on manual processes, reduce operational cost, and provide useful data for business analytics. And in fact, theoretically, it is possible to trace the product back all the way of every raw material that went into the product, when it into the product, what are the characteristics. All these things might be possible by application of the RFID. So, let us briefly that compare between that RF and microwave heating. The RF heating product should be of regular and simple insay, whereas in the case of microwave heating, there is no limitation of the shape of the product. In RF heating, normally lower frequencies and longer penetration depth are there. In the microwave, higher frequencies and lower penetration depth are involved. RF heating, no waveguide, and there is uniform field distribution. In the case of microwave heating, there is a waveguide and complex non-uniform standing wave patterns. RF heating is normally a directional heating, one directional heating, and microwave heating is a uniform all directional heating. Also, there are similarities between RF and microwave heating. RF and microwave heating both are rapid and volumetric. Radio frequency waves and microwaves transfer to treated products by radiation. Both RF and microwave heating take place due to the polarization effect of the electromagnetic field radiation. Both radio frequency and microwave systems are capable of instantaneously applying and removing the heat source. Microwave systems have been recognized to be 50% to 70% heating efficient in comparison with 10% heating efficiency with the conventional ovens. Both microwave and RF heating are non-ionizing radiations. Here it is a pictorial comparison between the microwave and radio frequency dryers. You can see here in the microwave, as we already discussed in the earlier class, it has a generator, alright, and through which the microwaves are generated through with the help of waveguide, and they are passed here, and this internal heating. Whereas, in the case of radio frequency dryer, you can see there is the RF generator, this RF voltage is passed through these two electrodes, and the food is held between in these two electrodes. So, it is electromagnetic radiation which enters into the food and then it gets heated internally. So, this shows the clear cut differentiation between the working principles of these two processes. Radio frequency heating is advantageous in many ways. It has or it results in increased throughput and are shorter process lines. It has improved energy efficiency, improved control. It is a contactless heating. The equipment is simpler in construction and space saving. It does not require lot of space for its cluster. It has increased power penetration, improved moisture leveling and uniform moisture distribution, and improved food quality through selective heating. So, the best thing is that you can maintain the quality of the heating or heated product or quality of the processed products. This friends, now in these two lectures, in this lecture and in the earlier lecture, we have seen that how this dielectric heating, it has a great potential in application of food processing industries. Both the radio frequency heating and microwave heatings, they can be used for various purposes in the food industry. They can be used successfully for the advantage to the both industry to the consumer. They can be used for extending the shelf life of the food materials. They can be used for processing or making good quality product or value addition into the product for improving the process efficiency and so on. However, these processes need to be applied or used, of course, with the caution. That is because here that the equipment etcetera should be properly designed and properly constructed. Thank you.